Note that in specifying concentrations, care must be exercised in distinguishing between two different concentrations, the delivered one and the in-situ spatial one. Their definitions differ, and so can differ their values in slurry flow. The spatial volume concentration, CVI, is defined as a ratio of the volume of solids and the total volume of mixture within the pipe, while the delivered concentration, CVD, is the ratio of volumetric flow rates of the solids and mixture. The difference in values of the two concentrations depends primarily on the type of slurry flow. Due to the broad range of possible sizes of transported solid particles, slurries are not simple to classify. Yet, it is essential that we do so if we want to be able to properly design slurry transport systems. Different slurries can form quite different flow types with different flow patterns, exhibiting different flow behavior. A slurry of particles smaller than, say, 40 microns tends to behave as a homogeneous slurry. The distribution of particles is virtually uniform throughout the flow. The distribution of particle velocities is axisymmetric across the pipe cross-section, and there is no local slip between the velocity of particles and velocity of carrying fluid. Some homogeneous slurries behave as Newtonian slurries, and they flow in the turbulent regime in a pipe. Others behave as non-Newtonian slurries, exhibiting either a laminar or turbulent flow regime in a pipe. A slurry of somewhat larger particles, say between 40 and 200 micron, which is the fine scent range, exhibits a slightly different behavior, called pseudo-homogeneous flow. The flow is Newtonian at all concentrations of solids and usually turbulent. The particles tend to separate from the carrying liquid at very low velocities. But if the mean velocity of flow is sufficiently high, as typical in industrial applications, all particles will be supported by turbulent diffusion. There would be a weak concentration gradient with a measurable decrease of concentration with increasing height in a pipe cross-section. The corresponding velocity distribution would be slightly asymmetrical, and the local slip would be negligible. If the size of transported particles is in the range of the medium scent range, typically between 200 and, say, 800 micron, the flow exhibits heterogeneous behavior, with smaller values of flow velocity producing greater non-uniformity of distributions of both solids concentration and solids velocity. For grains of sizes between, say, 800 microns and 1.5% of the pipe diameter, typically coarse sand and fine gravel, the heterogeneous flow becomes more distinctly stratified with a detectable sliding bed, and the transported grains can be supported either by turbulent eddies or by mutual collisions above the sliding bed. This partially stratified flow has profiles of both local concentration and velocity composed of two distinct parts. The approximately uniform distribution spans across the sliding bed, and the steep gradient of the profiles occurs in flow just above the bed. The pipe cross-section average slip is significant, and thus the delivered concentration CVD is smaller than the spatial concentration CVI. Fully stratified flow occurs if virtually all of the transported particles occupy the bed and turbulent suspension of particles is ineffective. The concentration profile exhibits a sharp gradient at the interface between the bed and the carrier flow above the bed, and this affects also the local velocity distribution. The area of the sharp gradient is associated with the part of the bed sheared by the flow and it is called a shear layer. The mean slip in a pipe cross-section tends to be significant, and typically the delivered concentration is much smaller than the spatial concentration. Fully stratified flow is less likely if the transported particles are broadly graded. Complex slurry flow carries coarse particles in a non-Newtonian carrier fluid, which itself is a mixture of fluid, usually water, and very fine particles. An identification of the flow types and patterns is essential for modeling of slurry flows in a pump pipeline transport system.